Chapter 8, Section 2. Now we're starting to get into reaction types. So the overview picture is we have combination reactions. What you're looking for are two reactants by themselves. So something like A plus B. If their products are given, it's even more obvious. It'll just simply bring them together. Decomposition, you're looking for one thing, one compound by itself. Notice there's no plus sign like above. Single replacement, you're looking for an element in its pure state with some sort of usually ionic compound. And double displacement, most likely is two ionic compounds, A click B plus C click D. The final one we'll spend more detailed time with later is combustion. What I'd like to say is some sort of carbon compound in the presence of oxygen, and almost always it makes carbon dioxide plus water. In the more detailed notes later, we'll talk about incomplete combustion, where instead of making carbon dioxide, you may make carbon monoxide or simply just carbon. Okay, number 13 is a synthesis reaction. So the way you recognize it is you have beryllium plus oxygen. It's a single element in a pure state with another single element in a pure state. So they're going to combine to form beryllium oxide. And what you have to figure out is that the product, you have to crisscross the product in this case. Beryllium's 2 plus, oxygen's 2 minus. So those two cancel out. Then you have to balance using coefficients. Oxygen, there's 2 on one side, on the reactant side. And so we're going to put a 2 in the coefficient there. And that'll make it 2 beryllium's. So we need to come back over here to the reactant side and put a 2 coefficient. And then a 1 in front of the oxygen. You don't have to write the 1. I'll put it in there just for emphasis sake. So it's 2 to 1 to 2. Okay. Number 15 is a decomposition reaction. And the way you know that is HI is all by itself. So it just is going to break apart into its components. Hydrogen's diatomic. Iodine is diatomic. So that's the challenge on these kind of problems, to make sure to write that. Then simply we need to balance. And there's 2 hydrogens, 2 iodines, so all you have to do is put a 2 in front of the HI. Now, number 15, or the next one, 15B, the product that's formed is magnesium chloride plus oxygen. They show you that magnesium chloride. And what I'm saying is, on these decomposition ones, it's often very difficult to predict the products. So please, just it's okay to look at the back to get products. On a test, I will always give you the products, but I may give them to you in word form, like you're shown above. Magnesium chloride, so you'll need to crisscross that. And oxygen, you'll need to know is diatomic. I'm going to hit rewind. Okay. Single displacement reactions, number 17. Let's take a look at iron solid. Notice that the iron will end up switching places with the lead. On B, you have to pay attention because that's a halogen gas, and so the chlorine will end up switching places with the iodine. So when you're doing single displacement reactions, it's good to look at the big picture first. So let's take a closer look at iron. Iron will switch places with the lead, and so the lead will go from an aqueous state and actually form a solid. The iron is going to go into solution, and we have to guess whether it's iron 2 or iron 3. So let's just go ahead and say it's iron 2. Then it's time to balance, and then you look at it. There's one iron, one lead, 2 nitrates. So this is balanced as is. Okay, let's take a look at number 17B. Chlorine gas will combine with sodium iodide. So this time, you have a halogen, so it's going to have a single displacement reaction with the iodine. So the iodine will come out of solution and form a gas, and you'll form sodium chloride in solution. And then it's important that we balance it. So if you take a look at chlorine, there's only one, and there's 2 on the other side, so we need a 2 for that coefficient. And and we need to come back over here and balance the sodium, so we'll put a 2. You can look at your iodines. There's two iodines over here, and so it's balanced. So again, remember the big difference: when you have iron by itself, it'll single displace with the lead. Chlorine is a halogen, it'll single displace with the anion, sodium iodide. The last type of reaction that we're going to talk about is number 18, double replacement reaction. And the way you recognize these, again, is you have an A click B with a C click D. These are usually ionic, so a cation with an anion plus a cation with an anion. And that's a good place to start and actually write in the charges, because it gets confusing with the subscripts. So sodium is plus, hydroxide minus, iron's 3+, and nitrate is minus. And how you know iron is 3+ is reverse crisscross. This 3 on the nitrate had to came from the iron. So this is iron 3. And so when you rearrange these and write the products, it's good to write them with the charges. So sodium's gonna go with nitrate, Na, NO3, Na is plus, NO3 is minus, plus the iron with the 3+, Fe3+, will combine with the hydroxide, polyatomic iron. And so we need to crisscross this one to make it FeOH3. Then we get rid of the charges, and it's time to balance using coefficients. We have 3 hydroxides, so we need to put a 3 there. That 3 applies to the sodium. So we need to put a 3 on the product side for the sodium nitrate. And then finally, irons look like they're balanced, so we can just put a 1.